Hey guys, we're going to be working on this art journal page today. It's been a long time, so you know how these things tend to go when it's been a while. I'm working in my 6x6 disc bound black joggles journal, and I'm starting out with some distressed oxides in spiced marmalade, picked raspberry, wilted violet, peacock feathers, and salty ocean. And I'm just going to apply the colors with my ink blending tool, and this paper is very thick and it has, I want to call it like a little coating, like the surface is very, like almost, I don't want to say slick, but almost, because the paper like takes a ton of water. But because of that, the oxides don't sink into the paper and they just kind of sit on top. And so with that being said, it's easy to blend them. I can even blend them with my finger, but because it's black paper, the colors aren't as vibrant, which is what I'm going for. I'm going for like a night sky. But I have to do a couple layers, and then after I'm done, I have to do something to fix them because they're going to always want to slide right off of the page. So I'm just going to go in with my colors a couple times until I'm happy with the intensity and the blend. And like I said, I can blend them a little bit with my finger, but I'm also using my ink blending tool. And then once I'm happy, I'm going to take some water to add some water droplets. I'm not even attempting to like dry it with a heat tool. So this is like immediately after we apply the inks. I'm just going to add some splatters and take those off. I think they look like little stars in the night sky. And then I'm going to add my favorite Heidi Swap Gold Color Shine. I don't even know if they make this stuff anymore. I got it so long ago, but it is seriously my favorite still for gold splatters. So I'm going to take my whole paper outside and spray it with a workable fixative. And I sprayed it with like three layers to make sure that those inks were really on there, because I'm going to add some wet glue and I don't want things moving around and looking all weird. So I have these tickets, vintage UK bus tickets, and the little package that you saw, I sell these on my Etsy shop, and the little package that you saw, the little envelope, all of them that I took out is what you would get if you bought them on my Etsy. But I wanted, trying to make them look like buildings, so I wanted them a little taller. So these are like a little bit longer. If you buy them from my Etsy and you want like more than one package, I can keep them together if you want, but you could always connect them. You wouldn't be able to tell, you know, that it was cut if you got two packs and they were cut. It's not that big of a deal. I could have done it like that. I just wanted them a little taller. So I'm gonna apply my tickets with some Collage Posh mats, and the numbers on them match the distress ink really nicely, like the purple of the numbers of the, is that a 12p and match the wilted violet, and then the 13 matches the picked raspberry. I thought it matched really cool. So I'm also going to cut some of my strips down a little bit, use some as they are, and just layer them up until I'm happy with the way they look. And then I'm going to go over the whole thing with a layer of the Collage Posh mat. Now you could skip this step. I'm going to add my Stabilo Marksol, and the paper would take the color or the black from the Marksol. It would like soak into the paper of the tickets and you would get a different look, but I wanted it to sit on top because I wanted to blend it out with some water. So I'm just going to take my Stabilo Marksol and go along the sides of them to make like a little bit of a shadow, and I'm adding the most intense line at first to the right side, and then really I just put the black lines all around them. But some of the ones, like you can see there, when I'm working on the building, quote unquote, that's behind the pink, I'm letting the Stabilo really cover that so it looks like a shadow back there. And I think it would be really cool to do this technique. My first idea was to do it with the Dina Wakely washi tape, and I never got around to making a page like that. And then I got these tickets and I thought, oh, these would be perfect for that. So you could use strips of paper, washi tape, all kinds of stuff to make these buildings. And you could also cover them with gesso, but I wanted to make sure that the tickets, like everything from the tickets, really shone through. So I'm cutting out a little bit of the tickets part, and then I'm gonna take some scrap canvas I have and just stitch around. I wanted to make them kind of look a little bit like windows. I realize they're a lot bigger than the window than the actual buildings, because they would have to be really small, and I probably couldn't get that through my sewing machine. But you know, it is what it is. And then I ran the whole outside around my sewing machine, but not the side where it's gonna go into my journal. So just on three sides, it has sewing on it. And I just added my little windows with some multimedia mat, and I'm gonna pop it right back into my journal. I was gonna add a quote, but I didn't, after I put the windows, I didn't know where to put it, and I didn't know what, so I just let it as it is, and I really liked the way it turned out. So I have these packs for sale in my Etsy if you're interested. If not, like I said, there's so many other things you could use to do this technique. I'm excited to use these tickets in other ways too. I'm super excited to get them, and I'm super excited to share them with you guys as well, because oh, I just love them so much. I think they're so cool. And yeah, so thank you so much for watching, and I will talk to you guys soon. Bye-bye, guys.